Eric Lindros lived up to the price tag a first overall draft pick carries in a number of ways. But one decision would change the course of his career and the team that drafted him forever. Welcome back to another episode of Alternate Hockey History, the series where we revisit key moments throughout hockey history to see how an alternate outcome might have changed the history of the sport. In today's episode, we are going to be taking a look at this Hall of Fame power forward's NHL career and asking the question, what if Eric Lindros played for the Quebec Nordiques? To remind you of the events that actually took place, allow me to take you back to the 1991 NHL entry draft. Lindros, the clear favourite to be selected at the top of the draft class, was selected first overall by the Quebec Nordiques, despite Lindros expressing that he would never play for the Nordiques due to the city's isolation and lack of marketing potential. Lindros was even threatening to remain in the juniors if he was selected by Quebec and would remain there unless he was traded away from the Nordiques. Quebec refused to trade their franchise's new supposed centrepiece until the 1992 NHL entry draft, after a year of Lindros refusing to play for the team and remaining in the minors. Despite some confusion as to which team had actually acquired him, since Quebec had accepted two different trade offers from two different teams, Lindros was traded to the Philadelphia Flyers in exchange for Steve Duchesne, Ron Hextall, Kerry Huffman, Mike Rickey, Peter Forsberg, the 7th overall pick in the 1992 draft, which was eventually changed to 1994 first-round pick Chris Simon, a 1993 first-round pick, and $15 million. After the trade, Lindros would finally join the NHL and go on to play 13 seasons in the league, eventually retiring at 34 years old due to continued concussion problems. But what if Lindros didn't request to be traded? What if he had played for the Quebec Nordiques? How would his career have been different? If Lindros had played for the Canadian franchise, the 1991 and 1992 drafts certainly would have been a lot less dramatic. If Lindros had embraced the team that drafted him first overall and entered the NHL with Quebec, a lot of what makes Lindros' draft year and the following draft when he was traded so memorable nowadays would be gone, and both drafts would likely be considered just more of the same, normal, somewhat forgettable events that normal hockey fans are used to in the hockey world nowadays. Also, it's possible that Lindros' career, if he had played for Quebec, could have turned out completely differently. In 760 NHL games, Lindros scored 372 goals and 493 assists for 865 points, as well as scoring 57 points in 53 playoff games. However, if he had played in Quebec with the likes of Matt Sundin, Joe Sakic and Owen Nolan, then perhaps he could have had even better numbers, have climbed even higher up the list of the NHL's best players, and cemented himself as one of the best to ever take to the ice in the league, even more so than he did in reality. Sure, he was playing with the likes of Rod Brind'Amour and Mark Recchi in Philly, but it's certainly possible that Lindros played even greater with the future legends that Quebec had on their roster at the time. In addition, there is a case to be made that Lindros might have had a longer and more successful career had he not played the heavy physical style of the Philadelphia Flyers early in his career. If Lindros doesn't play for the Flyers, he doesn't ice in any of their fixtures, and potentially doesn't get injured in the games that he did. Perhaps by playing for the Nordiques, Lindros doesn't suffer one, two, or any of the concussions that he did in Philly that were the primary cause of him ultimately ending his career when he was only 34 years old. Considering he suffered 6 concussions in 2 years as a member of the Philadelphia Flyers, you can see why concussions were such an ongoing problem for Lindros throughout his playing career. That's a hell of a lot of damage in such a short period of time. Of course, Lindros was still likely to have gotten injured at some point in his career, as injuries do happen in hockey. And if he had played for Quebec, there is the possibility that he does still suffer 1, 2, or many concussions if he played for the Nordiques due to his physical power forward style of play. But you never know. Maybe he would have avoided several injuries that he suffered and went on to play 15 to 20 seasons in the league, retire with the team that drafted him, and have his jersey hang high up in the rafters of the Quebec Colorado franchise. Or maybe he gets traded in his prime years and leads a contending team to a Stanley Cup championship. something he never achieved in reality. Since Lindros' career was so riddled with injury, all of this is certainly interesting food for thought. But the party that this alternate reality likely would have affected the most is the Quebec Nordiques. Let's not forget that the huge haul of Steve Duchesne, Ron Hextall, Kerry Huffman, Mike Rickey, Peter Forsberg, Chris Simon, a 1993 first-round pick, and $15 million Quebec acquired for Lindros either remained with Quebec or were used as trading chips to bring in future players, which helped the Nordiques win the Stanley Cup shortly after they relocated to Colorado. If the team doesn't trade Lindros, they don't get players like Peter Forsberg and Mike Rickey, who both became key players for the team for many years and helped the franchise win one or several of the team's Stanley Cup championships. If Quebec doesn't get these players, who's to say that Colorado wins one or either of its Stanley Cup championships? Perhaps they would be just like the 10 NHL teams that still have yet to lift the Stanley Cup in their franchise's history. On the flip side of the trade, whilst the Philadelphia Flyers would get a former first overall pick, giving up all the assets they did to get him did nothing to improve their chances at winning a Stanley Cup. In the 8 seasons that Lindros played for the Flyers, Philadelphia won 0 cups, had 1 finals exit, 2 conference finals exits, 1 second round exit, 2 first round exits, and 2 seasons where they missed the playoffs. Compare that to the Quebec Colorado franchise in this time span, and they won 1 Stanley Cup, 0 finals losses, 3 conference finals losses, 0 second round exits, 3 first round exits, and 1 season where they missed the playoffs, and it's pretty clear that the Nordiques Avalanche franchise had a lot more success as a result of the trade, especially by winning their first Stanley Cup in franchise history. If the trade never happens, perhaps the records would be reversed and Philadelphia would have won a cup in this time period. It's certainly possible, given the talent that they gave away to get Lindros, that ended up being key pieces in the Avalanche's early success. Also, it could be argued that if Lindros had stayed in Quebec, perhaps the Nordiques don't relocate to Colorado. With a first overall pick as the future poster boy and centerpiece of their franchise, maybe the team can get enough fans through the gates and enough money into the vault to allow the team to remain in Quebec. Whilst this is an interesting idea to ponder, due to the limited market availability of Quebec and the small area of influence the franchise carried compared to other teams in the league, it's more likely that Quebec still does relocate to Colorado. I mean, the team is still in Colorado, so you can't really say the choice to move there was such a bad idea, as they've done pretty well for themselves since moving. So, in conclusion, if Eric Lindros had stayed in Quebec and played for the Nordiques, the fate and success of 2 NHL teams could have changed completely. Quebec wouldn't have picked up some key players that helped them win their 2 Stanley Cup championships, whilst Philadelphia might have kept the pieces that could have put them over the top to win some silverware of their own. Lindros might have been able to keep the franchise that drafted him in Canada and may have avoided several of the concussions that ultimately ended his career early. But regardless of where Lindros could or should have played, one thing's for sure. 865 points in 760 games, 7 All-Star appearances, and a Hart Trophy in 13 seasons, despite retiring at 34 years old, is enough to show that Eric Lindros had an incredible NHL career and likely would have had a great career wherever he had played. And there you go. What do you think would have happened if Lindros had played for the Quebec Nordiques? Also, is there another alternate hockey history you would like me to explore as part of this series? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear what you guys think. But thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you have enjoyed. Please feel free to like, subscribe, share, or watch some of my other videos. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye. A big thank you to Chris Gadsby and Max Artis for helping support this video via Patreon. If you too want to help support the channel a little bit further and get a shout out at the end of any future videos, make sure you head over to patreon.com/oddmanrush and become a patron today.